How about we take a quick look at stream velocity? What I constructed there for you is a bisected stream. In other words, the river itself is cut in half and the water is flowing at you. If you look, where is the water moving fastest? Position A, position B, position C, position D, or position E? Just so you know what each one of these represents and where in the stream they are, A is in the middle of the river, but near the surface, still submerged though. B is in the middle of the river at the surface. C is along the left bank. D is along the bottom, the bed. E is over on the right bank. Which one of these is the water moving fastest at? Let me give you a hint. Friction is going to slow the water down, and water can act like a lubricant. Think about a slip and slide. You know, one of these things, you put water on it and then you run and you slide on it and you fall and hit your head. Or if you're driving your car on a day when it's dry outside and you slam your brakes on, versus you're driving your car on a day and you slam your brakes on and it's raining outside. Okay, having said that, okay, if you take a look at this diagram, you can see where it's at. The fastest water is just below the surface in the middle of the stream. The reason is because the other places all have friction going on. C, D, and E have friction with the land, which is going to slow the water down. B has friction with the air. Friction with the atmosphere? Are you kidding? Well, if you've ever been in a car that's going 50 miles an hour and the windows open and you stick your arm outside, I am not suggesting that. But if you have ever seen of it or heard of it happening or done it yourself, what happens to your arm? Your arm gets blown backwards. And your arm is blown backwards by friction with the atmosphere. Notice the impact of depth on velocity and how this changes in a meandering stream. If you look at A on the upper right-hand side, you can see that the water is deeper along that right bank, which is the outside cut bank. And you can see where the fastest velocity is at, which is represented by the dark color blue. Then if you look at B, you know, look at the stream to the left-hand side, you can see where B is bisecting the stream. Now you can see that right in the middle, but below the surface, that's going to be maximum velocity. And then look at C, when the bend comes around and now the cut bank is on the left-hand side, notice the water's deeper over there and the maximum velocity area switches over to that side. Sorry, I stumbled a little bit on that, but sometimes I stumble. That's me. I could cut it and edit it, or I could just leave it as is. Punk rock. We're going punk rock.